Okay, good morning dear students. So today we are going to discuss with one law. It is called as what? Raoult's law. Raoult's law is a law to study the vapor pressure of different binary solutions. What happens to the vapor pressure of the solution? If you are going to add non-volatile solute to a volatile solvent, and if you are going to add both the volatile liquids in a solution, that means what, both the solutes as well as the solvents are volatile chemical solutions. Okay, let us go through its statement. It is very important one. It is very important one. What is the statement means? Look at here. The partial vapor pressure of each component of the solution at a given temperature is directly proportional to its mole fraction that is present in the solution. It is very important. What they are telling, the partial vapor pressure of each component of the solution. Say for example, if you consider there is a solution in flour test, the solute and solvent. If you consider the partial vapor pressure of each component means both the solution and solvent of the solution, a given temperature, it is directly proportional to its mole fraction of the solution. So this is what the statement. Okay, you consider Raoult's law for the solution containing two volatile liquids. So let us consider both the components are volatile chemical substances. That means what? Both the solutes as well as solvent in the solutions are in a volatile state. Then what happens to its vapor pressure? So let us go through here. Consider a binary solution of two liquids. We will consider a solution, and that solution it is consisting of two components. So because of that we can able to say that this is what, a binary solution. And in that solution two components are there. Which are those means? One is A and one is B. So here consider a binary solution of two liquids A and B. Let PA and PB are the partial pressures of A and B respectively. Here we have considered the two components that A and B. A is having its partial pressure PA and B is having its partial pressure PB. Then according to these mole fractions of A and B are respectively, if you consider Raoult's law, we know that partial vapor pressure of a solvent is directly proportional to xA means what, the mole fraction of a solvent according to this statement. Once again I will tell you, PA is directly proportional to xA means what, here A is nothing but the solvent, B is nothing but what, the solute. The partial vapor pressure of a solvent is directly proportional to mole fraction of that solvent in the solution, and PA is directly proportional to the xB means what, partial vapor pressure of a solute is directly proportional to xB. And here we can consider PA that is equal to, if you are going to remove this proportionality constant, then you will get PA that is equal to PA naught into xA, where PA naught is nothing but what, the vapor pressure of pure component. So before the addition of the solute and the solvent in the solution, that the solute and the solvent A and B is rather its own vapor pressure, then we will call that is equal to what, the pure vapor pressure of that component. So for that we can write PA that is equal to PA naught into xA, and PB that is equal to PB naught into xB, where PA naught and PB naught are the vapor pressure of pure components of A and B respectively. Then if the vapor pressure behaves as an ideal gas, then according to Dalton's law of partial pressure, we know that according to Dalton's law, what is there? PS, the total pressure of a system, the total pressure of a solution, that is equal to partial vapor pressure of a solvent and partial vapor pressure of a solute. So that means what? According to the Dalton's law of partial pressure, we know that the total vapor pressure of an ideal gas, that is equal to sum of the partial pressures of individual components in the solution or in the gas. So for that we have considered total vapor pressure P total, or we PS. PS means what? Total vapor pressure of a solution, that is equal to partial vapor pressure of A plus partial vapor pressure of B. But PA, we know that PA that is equal to PA naught into XA, and PB that is equal to what is that? PB naught into XB. So let us substitute these values in case of this formula, then we will get P total or PS that is equal to PA means what? PA naught into XA, and PB is nothing but what? PB naught into XB. And we know that according to the mole fraction concept, the mole fraction of a solute plus mole fraction of a solvent, that should be equal to 1 or unity. So for that we know that mole fraction of A plus mole fraction of B, that is equal to 1. Okay, if you take XB, then it will go to the right hand side, then it will become as XB that is equal to 1 minus XA. So we need to substitute this value in this expression, in the above expression. That means what? XB means what? We need to substitute here. Then the expression will become P total or PS that is equal to PA naught into XA. It is like as that only. Plus PB naught into XB is nothing but what? 1 minus XA. Or P total or PS that is equal to what is that? PB naught. If you multiply this here, 1 into PB naught, PB naught. Sorry, you take this word, okay, directly I have considered PA naught into XA plus PB naught minus PB naught into XA will become. Then we can write, what we can able to write it here? PB naught plus XA, XA is going to become common. Then we have to take it outside. Then we can write this as PA naught minus PB naught. So this is what? Equation number 1. Okay, let us consider, or we can able to write that PS, oh, we need to take what is the XB. If you need to take S, the XB means what we can able to write? XA that is equal to 1 minus XB. Okay, if you substitute this value in case of this XA, then you will get this value that PS that is equal to PA naught plus XB into PB naught minus PA naught. So this is what equation number 2. Then, what will happen? If you consider by the equations, what we get to that the total vapor pressure of a solution can be related to the mole fraction of any one component, either it will be XA or it will be PXB. But I'm telling the total vapor pressure of a solution, it is mainly depends on, that is related to the mole fraction of any one component in a solution, either it is XA or it is XB. Come to the next conclusion that the total vapor pressure of the solution varies linearly with the mole fraction of A or mole fraction of B. The total vapor pressure of a solution that will vary, that will change in according with the mole fraction of the solute as well as the solvent. Did you got this? Come to the third one. Depending on the vapor pressure of the pure components, that is what PA naught and PB naught, total vapor pressure over the solution decreases or increases with increase in the mole fraction of the component A. Same is true for the what is the mole fraction of B. So these three are the conclusions we can able to get it by these two equations. By these two equations, we have got these conclusions. Come to the next one, graphical representation. Graphical representation. You consider the limit about this. Limit about this. Here this is the vapor pressure, and this is called as what XA. Look at here. As the mole fraction increases, vapor pressure of the solvent it goes on increases. And I have got here at XA that is equal to 1. Look at here. XA that is equal to 1 means what? The vapor pressure is increases like this, it will become PA. And if XB is equal to 0 and XA is equal to 0, as the mole fraction increases, vapor pressure is goes on increases. If you join these two joint things, we will get P total, our particular to write PS that is equal to PA plus PB. So this is what we can able to say, graphical representation. So you should remember here. Because of while explaining the ideal and non-ideal solution, this is very very important. Come to the next one. Raoult's law as a special case of Henry's law. Look at here, if you consider Raoult's law, we have two laws. One is Henry's law, one more is what is that? The Raoult's law. What they are telling? Raoult's law as a special case these are the special case of what is the Hilbert's law, how it means. Okay, let us consider according to Raoult's law. We know that what we know, PA that is equal to PA naught into XA. Did you got PA that is equal to PA naught into XA? You call this is what equation number one. Next, according to Hilbert's law, what we know that P that is equal to KH into XA. Here, pressure are same. Mole fraction is the same, but only differences are its constants. That means what? PA naught and KH. So because of this reason, we can able to say Raoult's law, it is a special case of what is that Henry's law. Come to the next one, that vapor pressure of a solution containing non-volatile solid, a volatile solid. Look at your ideas today. Easily can able to say, you take two beakers. Those two beakers containing one is a solute and one is a solid. You have to mix it. Both the chemical substances are volatile chemical substances. If you are going to mix that, then it can able to produce its vapor pressure. That vapor pressure, it is equal to the sum of the partial vapor pressure of solutes and solid. If you are going to sum it, then that is equal to total vapor pressure. That is one case. Okay, you take another two beakers. In one beaker, you consider non-volatile solution. What is that? Non-volatile solution. In another beaker, you consider volatile solution. So it is non-volatile. It's volatile. Here, the vapor pressure of the non-volatile chemical substance is zero. The vapor pressure of the solvent, the volatile solvent, is what? Somewhat. If you are going to mix this non-volatile solution in a volatile solvent, then the total vapor pressure, that is equal to what? Vapor pressure of the partial vapor pressure of the solvent only, but not solute. Why? Because of, if you consider that solute, it is a non-volatile chemical substance. Then what we can apply? PS that is equal to PA plus PB means PA is the partial vapor pressure of solvent, PB is the partial vapor pressure of solute. Then if PB that is equal to 0, because of partial vapor pressure that is equal to 0, what it will become? PS that is equal to, we can able to write PA or PA only, but not equal to PB, because of we are going to add non-volatile solute. So this is the concept we have here. What is that? Raoult's law for the solution containing non-volatile solid in liquid. So according to this, the vapor pressure of a solution containing non-volatile solute is directly proportional to the mole fraction of the solvent only. What is that? Mole fraction of the solvent only. Because of, if you know, that is a volatile chemical substance. Okay. Consider a binary solution containing two components A and B. Here A is volatile liquid, B is non-volatile solid substance. Then the vapor pressure of the solution is due to the vapor pressure of solvent only, but vapor pressure of solute we are not considered because of it is non-volatile. Okay, if you consider XA and XB are the mole fractions, then according to the Dalton's Raoult's law, vapor pressure of the solution is directly proportional to mole fraction of the solvent. Did you get what I'm telling? At a given temperature, the vapor pressure of a solution is directly proportional to mole fraction of the solvent. Then we can write PA that is directly proportional to XA. If you remove this, it will become PA that is equal to K into XA, where K is nothing but what? Proportionality constant. Look at here. For pure liquids, mole fraction of that is equal to 1. For any pure liquids, mole fraction of that is equal to 1. Then K becomes equal to the vapor pressure of the pure solvent, which is denoted by PA0. PA0 means what? If KXA that is equal to 1, mole fraction that is equal to 1, then we can write this as PA0. Then instead of this K, we can write this as PA0. If you are going to draw a graph, means what? It is just like y is equal to mx plus c. In y axis, you consider vapor pressure of solvent. In x axis, you consider vapor pressure mole fraction of solvent. Then you will get one line. This is what? Mole fraction of what is the partial vapor pressure of a pure solvent. Then look at here. As the mole fraction increases, or as the pressure increases, mole fraction goes on, increases. So this is the graph. Okay, by this information, what we came to know that a binary solution containing two non-volatile liquids, for that the total vapor pressure pressure that is equal to what? The total vapor pressure that is equal to the sum of the partial vapor pressure of the solvent. And if you consider a solution, a binary solution containing non-volatile solid in volatile liquid, means what we can write? The total vapor pressure of the solution that is equal to the vapor pressure of the partial vapor pressure of the pure solid only. So this is the concept we discussed here. You got this? Come to the next one. It is that ideal and non-ideal solution.